Paul and Silas, the Bible says, had come to talk to the Philippians, because a vision of a man speaking came to Paul while he was sleeping. And the vision of the Macedonian man said to him, come help us, Paul and Silas. In Acts 16 they walked around, tried to get to know the town, went to pray down by the river, met a lady there named Lydia. They baptized her there, and she asked if it be alright, come spend the night and stay a while at my house. They met a slave girl later on, who made her masters quite a lot. Fortune telling was her occupation, had a spirit of divination. It was driven out when Paul said Jesus' name. And so they came and arrested Paul and Silas, threw them right into the jail. Paul and Silas' faith prevailed. Prisoners at midnight heard them praising God that they were Christ's servants. Then an earthquake came and shook the jail and let go from the cell Paul and Silas. Jailer bowed and prayed, what must I do to be saved? And they said, believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will receive his forgiveness. Paul and Silas taught the words of the gospel to him and his entire house, and everyone now is in heaven with Paul and Silas.
Hello, dark and light-skinned men. Division swiftly breeding, and it leaves our loved ones bleeding. And the crimson blood that ran red in their veins spills the same when there's the sound of sirens. And rocks are thrown, and terror seeks out troubled souls. We need the Savior of every man. He'll turn our colors into goldness hands. But our eyes are set on the flesh, so we see our fight black and white, and thus the sound of sirens. And on the news tonight I saw just how the people hate the law. People shot dead without speaking without was the sound of sirens. Fools that riot do not know Satan's quite a clever foe. Hear the word or he might beat you. Take a button, he might eat you. But the best, Ephesians 6 verse 12, it echoes in the wails of sirens. And if people now will those grounds.